I will talk on megalithic journeys, mobility and maritime interaction in Europe in the 5th and 4th millennium Carl BC. I will present a collection of evidence and indications for maritime journeys of megalithic societies based on radiocarbon dates and chronological modeling, the circulation of greenstone artifacts and megalithic art. My name is Bettina Schulz Paulsson. I'm from the University of Gothenburg, and I'm working since a couple of years at megaliths in Europe, and I will show here the results of different projects. Megaliths, and this is including megalithic graves, standing stones, megalithic buildings, are worldwide phenomena. And in Europe, there are still remaining around 35,000 megaliths, and most of them have been constructed in the Neolithic and in the Copper Age, and they're located along the coastal areas. And strikingly, in Europe and even worldwide, the appearance and the architectonic feature is similar or even identical. As we find throughout Europe, we find megalithic graves built as dolmens and passage graves or gallery graves. Then we have all around Europe standing stones, either isolated in the landscape or they're arranged in circles or in rows. And furthermore, there is evidence for all over Europe for the orientation of the graves to the east or the southeast towards the rising sun. It is an over 200 years old ongoing research debate when, where, how, and why megaliths and megalithic societies are emerging. And during the 19th and the first two-thirds of the 20th centuries were archaeologists as Oscar Montelius and Gordon Child postulating theories with the origin of the megaliths in one region and the spread from there out. So presented Montelius in the 19th century the Orient as potential region where megaliths emerged. Or Gordon Child saw the origin of the passage graves in the Mediterranean and a diffusion outgoing from there over the seaway. With the introduction of the radiocarbon dates in the megalith research and the processualistic approach is this idea of an independent emerge of the same kind of stone architecture as in several regions arose. So Colin Renfrew proposed 5 independent nuclear centers, including Portugal, Andalusia, Brittany, Southwest England, and possible Ireland, for the emergence of megaliths in Europe. With my time and stone project, I tried to contribute to this debate, and I compiled and analyzed 2,410 radiocarbon results out of megalithic contexts, but also out of pre-megalithic and to the megaliths' contemporaneous contexts. And the results were re-evaluated after their context and their quality, and I was applying a Bayesian statistical framework. And Bayesian statistics and chronological modeling of radiocarbon dates is today a well-established method to considerably constrain the time interval for calibrated ranges. And we can come so to much more exact timelines. I could constrain this time interval for the emergence of megaliths in Europe to 200 to 300 years, and I found decisive support for the spreading of the megaliths over the seaway in 5 different phases. And the book is just out. I just want to say this is now, you can buy it at Archive Press. Brand new, still warm. And I want to present here quick the summarized results. Megaliths are emerging in northwest France in the 5th millennium, called the sea between 4,700 and 4,000. It's the region with the earliest possible onset for the data and the only region where we can consider transitional stages to the megaliths. And within the same time interval or somewhat later, we have megaliths in Catalonia, on Sardinia, then in Galicia, possible in Algarve, in Andalusia, and in northern Italy, also Apulia. These are regions where we only have the material and the architecture. There's no direct radiocarbon dates existing yet. Then within the same time interval, also I have to say this early megalithic stage is associated to closed structures. These are schists or chambers, and they're covered by mounds. In the same time interval, we have passage graves. Also it starts here in north of France and Corsica, that we have graves who were to reopen again and a change of the burial customs. And now it's happening. If you look between 4,000 and 3,500, all along the Atlantic facet, we have thousands of passage graves built. And there, also this is, it can be that they most probably were built within a very short time interval. I have no closer indications there yet. And we do not know what this is. So this is for sure spreading over the seaway, and we do not know, is it migration, is it intercultural exchange, or is it both, most probably, what I personally think. Then we have 500 years later, southern France in the family career, and also here in Scandinavia, it is like this, that the spread from the megalithic graves came over the seaway, because the earliest megalithic graves we have on the west coast of the island of Gotland and Öland, and these are staying the only megalithic graves on these islands. So it looks like they were coming, this passage grave tradition were coming from somewhere else to these islands. Then we have also the temples on Malta in this time. We have in the next 500 years only one new megalithic region in Belgium with the alecoveas, also with gallery graves. 500 years of stagnation, but reuse of older graves, also no new megalithic regions. And then between 2000 and 1000, again, spreading of megaliths in the Mediterranean over the seaway together with the bell beaker phenomenon. As I said, also Brittany is the region with the potential earliest radiocarbon dates, and we have beside this also the highest accumulation of greenstone artifacts, and especially jadeite and variscite. And this is another project I was working with colleagues from all over Europe, from Spain, Portugal, and France, and we tried to get the temporality of this greenstone train, also of this Calais trait, because Calais is a very raw material in Europe. We have only 10 clear sources, and together with provenience analyzers, also with the Calais project, we tried really to see how the circulation, also when the circulation was exact, and get a high precise chronology for this. And we tried to sort out really the reliable context, and in the end it was 405 left, and we were establishing large models like this for the regions, and the earliest Calais context we have from northern France and western Spain. And it looks like this now. Also green is the sources, small green dots are the artifacts, and this is for the 6th and 5th millennium codice. And we have in the end of the 6th millennium, we have from Cantin Touré outgoing, also provenience analysis from Keredol, these new ones, that Calais artifacts were found in, from there, originating from there, here in northern Spain, and in the Cueva de Cavas de Pastares. Then we got a really early Rubani context here up in the grave with Calais from Pico Centeno from Enkinazola, as a really long trade. And then the time of the first megaliths. This is here, also we have here this small with the highest accumulation of these beads and pearls. In this time, there's still Canti Touré is in use, the mine, but the analysis of this earliest megalithic raw material from Calais was given exclusively now after new knowledge, Pico Centeno and Enkinazola. And this is for me also an indication, as and you have to look here, there is no artifacts in this region. So it means either they traded up the raw material, but what I think, rather that they went down to take it. And this must have been happening partly over the seaway. Then, what is the megalithic art saying? We have megalithic seascape, and we have maritime motifs depicted in megalithic art. There is this symbol is controversially debated. It's called partly still some kind of plow, but I think Serge Cassin was showing very, for me, plausible that it's a depiction of a sperm whale. Yes. What about the watercraft? We have also boats in megalithic graves. Here in Manalud, we have three boats on one autostat, and they're similar depicted as the Bronze Age boat in Scandinavia, also with a crew. Then we have here in Manalud, also one boat. In Gavrinis, also the record documentation was giving another boat. And what is also quite common are some barks in combination with the quadrat here. Then we have a symbol is called the U of Fowl motif, and it's normally interpreted as bowites or water birds. But if we look with our Scandinavian boat eye, since we have there only in our region over 10,000 boats, if you look at some example of boats, we could also interpret this symbol, if you see, for example, here, as a depiction of boats. And this is a quite common symbol in Brittany. So there are strong indications for long-distance maritime exchange and seafaring while the Neolithic in Europe, and this is 2,000 years earlier than Heturto proposed for the Bronze Age, and we have no evidence yet for the watercraft technology. Thank you very much.